Okay, hi everybody. So this is the first Let's Play on this channel, and we are going to play Doom Eternal, The Ancient Gods Part 2, which just got released today. And yeah, I finished already the campaign, the first one, and now I'm going to play Part 2. And let's see how this goes. Okay, so now we check the difficulty. I like to play it on the easiest one, to be honest, because I just want to enjoy the game and yeah, not suffer so much through it. Okay, and let's see the previously happened on. By the way, if you haven't played the game or are interested in the story, this is a major spoiler warning, of course, because yeah, I'm not really taking care of any story backgrounds. Okay, let's see. It seems we start with exactly what we had before. Okay. Let's quickly set up all of our weapons the way we had them. Beforehand, so it's a little bit sad that they don't just take the settings from the old game, because I would have really liked that, to be honest, but okay. Okie dokie.
You must power the gate of Doom with the Wraith's crystal and pass through to where the Dark Lord resides. He is waiting for you.
So this is the first Doom game, or the first game actually other than Cyberpunk that I'm playing on the Xbox Series X, and I must say it's so much faster. Like, you can feel that the performance is much, much better than the real console.
All
game is very different than Cyberpunk, to be honest. It does not waste our time with anything and throws us directly back into the action, and it really pretty surroundings. Actually, I was really stoked. The trailer was released yesterday, I think, and the teaser trailer 2 days beforehand. And this really, really made me happy. I was waiting for it a long time, and now it's finally there. Oops, I need to get ready for this. Oops. Okay, we have to jump in. Okay, this is a new thing. This I want to try again. Okay. Cute, it's like an 8-bit sound when you diminished it. Just like in the old Doom games, huh? What I really like also in the Ancient Gods part 1 was that it's much harder than the main game, I believe. And in addition, that it's so rewarding when you finish it, right? But I must say, other than that, I'm not actually a fan of the double shotgun. It's not much fun to use, I believe. I also played most of the main game with different kind of weapons. Thank you. this was already the mechanic in the first one. Where? Okay, so now, essentially here in this one, we don't take damage, or we don't take damage from the outside world. But apart from that, we are taking damage, and we need to now find the boss open. Jump behind them and then kill them from behind, but I find that really difficult, for me at least. Okay, so let's see. Okay, this seems to be a new... I think the Armor Baron is a new kind of monster. But... new ones. You can just find little nuances in them. It's quite engaging how they built the whole game and also the other ones. Conveniently waits and how nice he is, but he actually gives you a chance to kill his to kill his friends.
Okay.
goes over pink, right? But there's some meaning to it. Maybe that you should get a weapon energy, but that also the mechanic to get new ammunition is just easier. Oh yeah, here we see already the hammer, which is a new weapon, but we see it twice, so that means there must be some kind of new thing going on, and the level is actually quite small. So let's see. Here we see a level up. Okay, let's see where it goes. Ah, okay. Okay, so we know now that we need to continue playing actually a little bit in order to get here. Secret we found. But for example, we didn't get the extra life till now. This baffles me a bit. As it doesn't strike me as a game that would not do give it. But also the break, the wall don't look breakable. Is still missing, but it must also be some kind of mechanism that we use, because we can see on the map that it has no connection to anything else. But yeah, let's see what comes here now. And of course another battle area. I believe this is just a warm-up again. Most likely they're going. Oh god, no, please.